Dear students, welcome to this shared tutorial. In this opportunity, I'm going to focus on teaching vocabulary. So let's first focus on the definition of vocabulary. Vocabulary is a core component of language proficiency and provides much of the basis for how well learners speak, listen, read, and write. We can teach vocabulary using authentic texts. For example, we have newspapers, magazines, internet articles, advertisements, and other ones. Okay, it's important to use them because they provide valuable opportunities to teach new vocabulary. And also, the vocabulary can be taught from context. So it is important to teach it because, according to Silverstein, the ability to determine the meaning of vocabulary items from context is one of the most important aspects of successful reading. There are different activities that we can use in our classroom in order to make our students learn new vocabulary. For example, we as teachers can bring reading passages into the classroom, and then we can introduce new vocabulary through use of teacher-developed vocabulary from context formats. But not all the words are going to or need to be taught, because we need to select which ones are the candidates for inclusion in this type of exercise. But which words do qualify for inclusion in this type of exercise? Here we have some characteristics. The meaning is not available from the context provided. The word is likely to impede comprehension. And also, the word is frequent enough to be worth teaching. Another activity that we can use in our classroom is provide students with dictionaries, or students have to bring dictionaries into the classroom in order to use them. So it is important because students often benefit from instruction and practice using a monolingual using a English dictionary. But before asking students to use dictionaries, it is necessary that teachers introduce the elements of a dictionary entry. For example, each word that is included in a dictionary have different functions. For example, here we have the word provide, which functions as a verb and also it functions as a noun. And here also we have the meaning of each word according to the function that they have here. Some in other dictionaries also we find the examples of using those words according to the function. Okay, so it's important to make our students first identify which are the elements that the dictionary contains. And after that, we can ask students to work with words that are used in an unfamiliar way. It's important to use those words because they are good candidates for doing this kind of practice. Another activity is to make our students work with glossing. It is a technique available when bringing passages into the classroom that contain difficult vocabulary that is frankly not worth teaching. So, as an example of glossing, we have shared definitions provided in the form of a footnote or marginal note. It's important to mention that it's not necessary to use this technique with words that will not impede comprehension, because it's not necessary to understand every word that we have in a text, because even native speakers do not know the meaning of every term in their first language. So, as Silverstein mentions, knowing what one needs to know is a hallmark of the efficient reader. Thank you very much.